Everyone, hope everyone is doing well, managing okay. We're in the middle of the 9 days. This week is Shabbos Parshas Devarim, Shabbos Chazon, Tisha B'Av next week. I wanted to share a thought that is in Yonah de Yoma, that is relevant to the 9 days that we find ourselves in, but also perhaps relevant to the experience of COVID-19 that we're all suffering through and we're all challenged by. So the Yushalmi in Maseches Yuma. A Yushalmi that comes in different forms, in different fashions, but here there's a very fascinating lashon. Yushalmi says the Bais Rishon was destroyed because of the three cardinal sins, Avodah Zarah, Gilui Arayos, and Shvichus Damim. And then it says, however, Basheni, when it comes to the time of the Bais Sheni, Makir Manu Osam Sheyigim Batara, we knew many people that were very meticulous in their Torah learning, Vezihirim B'mitzvos, and they were careful about Shmiras HaMitzvos, U'B'masos, and they ate only food that had Shumas and Maisos done, and everything was seemed to be on the up and up. So why was the Bais Sheni destroyed? Ela, shayu ohavim es hamamon visonin elu la'elu. They loved money and they hated each other. And then the Yushalmi concludes with sinas chinam is shkula keneged the big three, the cardinal three sins. After all, the cardinal three, Avodah Zarah, Gilui Arayos, and Shvichus Damim destroyed the Bais Rishon, Sinas Chinam destroyed the Bais Sheni, and we're suffering 2,000 years later, so perhaps even more chamor. Interesting that Yushalmi equates and puts together, and Rav Asher Weiss explains that it's Ha Baha Talia, these are linked. O Havines HaMamon, when you love money, when you are desirous of money, so that can trigger very easily a Sinas Chinam. The two go hand in hand. Because capitalists, there's a certain competitive nature in capitalism. That's what it's built on, is that I work hard and I achieve and I keep score based on the money that I acquire. And part of my success is because, perhaps, again, psychologically, I am beating the neighbor. I am beating my competition. I am ahead, and that's what's causing my success. So inherent in that which is oeves hamamon can yield easily a sinas chinam, a disrespecting or perhaps even desiring the downfall of my colleagues. In fact, there's another amazing Yushalmi that Rav Asher Weiss quotes, Yushalmi Masechet Sanhedrin, that refers to Rabbi Yehuda Nasi, the author of the compiler of the Mishnayos. So we refer to Rabbi Yehuda Nasi as Rabbeinu HaKadosh. So the Yushalmi explains, this is also Gemara Masechet Shabbos, why was he called Rabbeinu HaKadosh, the holy Rabbeinu? Is Shelo Nistakel b'milaso miyamav. He never gazed at his Makom HaMila. He lived a life of Tahara, of Kedusha, never gazing at his Makom HaMila. But then there was another personality, someone named Nachum, and he was referred to as Nachum Ish Kodesh HaKadoshim. Why was he referred to as Nachum Ish Kodesh HaKadoshim? Not just Nachum HaKadosh, Rabbeinu HaKadosh, no. Nachum Ish Kodesh HaKadoshim Shol Nistakal Bitzuras Matbeya Miyamav. Because he never looked at the form of a coin in his days. And that elevated him to the level not just of HaKadosh, but Ish Kodesh HaKadoshim. Wow. That's an amazing contrast. And the Gemara is establishing that, yes, Rabbeinu HaKadosh, Rav Yehuda Nasi, was on a tremendously high level because he lived a life of Kedusha, of Tahara, of Shmira. But Nachum Ish Kodesh Kadoshim, he was very, very wary when it came to money, perhaps because when a person is too involved in money, that could easily lead to Averos, problems between Adam l'chavero, and ultimately sinas chinam, and ultimately churban beis hamikdash. So I want to apply this a little bit because we find ourselves in a life right now that we're encouraged very much to social distance, the right thing to do, separate from people. We're encouraged, perhaps even legally required, to wear masks. And by definition, when we wear masks, we can't really relate to others in the same way. We don't see their facial expressions. We're not really, really connecting to other people. And we're not supposed to be in that fashion. And social distancing creates distancing. And when I walk down the street, or when I'm in a shul, or when I'm in an outdoor minyan, I see every other person, potentially, this could be my mindset, I see every person as a threat to me. Perhaps he's an asymptomatic carrier. I have to keep my distance. He's a threat. The COVID phenomena that we find ourselves in, social distancing, masking, potentially creates in us an approach, an attitude that everyone is my enemy. Everyone's a threat to me. and I have to distance myself. It could create a latent psychological sense of Rachmana Litzlan Sina Schina. But it also could be flipped, because anyone who's involved will understand. So for example, when it comes to masks, so masking is certainly will help me, but the wearing of a mask is fundamentally an act of chesed, and it's there to help others. If I were to go ahead and wear a mask and blow through it, I won't feel anything on my hands, yet I can still breathe. So it's really helping others more than it's helping me. It's certainly helping me too, but not in the same level. It's helping others. It's fundamentally chesed. And as uncomfortable as masks might be, and as challenging as social distancing might be, if our mindset shifts and we shift into a mindset that when I'm putting on a mask, when I'm social distancing, it's not because I don't want to be close to him because he's a threat to me. No, on the contrary. I want not to be a threat to him. I want to help him. I want to be there for him. I want to protect him. And all of a sudden, it's not about me. And it's not about my selfishness and my taking. And he's a threat to me. On the contrary, I am engaging in chesed to him, to everyone else. And that shift turns every single act of social distancing, of masking, into a maisa hamitzvah, and to an act of chesed, into an act of ahava schina. And it's perhaps these modalities, this mindset, which in addition to being good for everyone's health, but can also be good for everyone's spiritual health. Let's not see other people as a threat to us, but let's see this opportunity as a modality of chesed, of giving, of caring for other people. And all of a sudden, all the social distancing is actually because I love you, not because you're a threat to me, because I love, because of Avas Chinam. And we should be zoche in doing all of these acts of Avas Chinam on a daily basis to bring the Bayis Shlishi, b'mheira v'yameinu. Amen.